Hey guys, it's Cass here again. Welcome to another video review. So today I'll be reviewing the Razer DeathAdder 2013 edition. So this mouse has been out for like a year now. A lot of people have been doing reviews, so I'll be doing like a comparison between this mouse, the 3500 DPI edition, and the original 1800 DPI edition. And I'm going to be doing some comparisons and mainly talking about the differences and whether or not you should get this mouse. So this is going to be a quick and short overview, really. So first of all, the differences between this and the originals is that The coding. The coding is actually extremely different. In the first and the second edition DeathAdders, they actually employed a somewhat smooth, very matte feeling, smooth-ish surface. So what this meant was if you sweat a lot before, the surface would actually deteriorate quite quickly. With the new DeathAdder 2013 edition, the surface is much more coarse, much more rougher. It's still a matte version. It's still a matte surface. However, it's much more sweat resistant, and I guess that's what they're going for, because with the quality control issues with the previous editions, that's why they switched to a completely new surface with the DeathAdder 2013 edition. They also changed like the side buttons actually on the side. Not the side buttons, sorry. First of all, on the side, they have side grip. And with the side grip, supposedly using your third and fourth fingers and your thumb, you're able to hold the mouse better. However, I didn't feel like the original DeathAdder with this glossy surface, mouse really slipped out of your hand anyway. So the fact that you added this grip, little rubber grip part, some people might like it. I personally not an extreme fan of it. Like, I don't mind it, I guess. But that is what is different. Next off, also with the side buttons. Side buttons, they also changed quite a bit. With the original side buttons, you can see it's quite glossy, it's quite the side buttons are quite loose, and they're quite clicky in this sense. The new DeathAdder 2013 side buttons are much harder. They're much more sturdy, they're much harder to press, in my opinion. So this is one thing that you might like, you might dislike. I personally like the old buttons more. Next thing that they change is actually the sensor. With all the refreshes, they refresh from the original 1800 DPI to 3500 DPI, and now to the S3988 sensor. So basically, they're all based on the same architecture. However, it's the Avogo sensor made only for Razer. Though the tracking is basically the same, however, the DPI has been increased to 6400 DPI. So in terms of tracking, is actually that much better than the original 3500 DPI version? Probably at the lower settings, probably not. However, if you tune it up to the 3500 or 6400 DPI settings, obviously this old mouse cannot go up to that, but the new DA 2013 edition can. So in that sense, if you are a high DPI gamer, you would like that, but personally, nobody really gains at that DPI. Anyways. Now onto the scroll wheel. So with Razer in their 2012 and 2013 editions, their mice have all taken a very tactile kind of scroll wheel. So you can feel the bumps a lot better compared to the older DA first edition, second edition. The indentations were not as easy to be felt. They're quite smooth and just glided. So it's a very, very rubbery feeling, if you guys can see from here. In the new one, it's much more sturdier. You can feel the bumps a lot better. So it's not as smooth, but some people might like this. I do personally prefer the new scroll wheel over the old scroll wheel. Last but not least, for the price. So for the price for the 3500 DPI version, you can probably find some on eBay. I'm selling some, obviously, but you can find other DeathAdder 3.5G versions for $40 or less, or secondhand even for like $30 or less. With this mouse, it does cost about $59, retails $69. You can probably find some for about $59, and I think there's some on eBay for like $54. So in terms of that, for the increased price, is it worth it? Well, I personally think that I actually like the surface of the original DeathAdder more for some reason, because it feels smoother on my hand. That's why I feel like it resembles the original DeathAdder. With the new DeathAdder, even though it's the same shape, I don't quite like the matte coating as much, but some people might like this anti-resistant, more coarse feeling of the DeathAdder more. Furthermore, I don't like the green color that much. I like the blue. I actually most like the original white indeed. So if you guys do want a complete refresh, if you haven't tried the DeathAdder before, this would be a good buy. If you guys have an original DeathAdder 3.5 or the original one and it's not quite working, this would be a good upgrade as well. But if that one's working, I wouldn't really recommend upgrading to this mount. So hope you guys like that short overview, and thanks for watching, guys.